Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about Browning reactions. Browning is one of the most important reactions taking place during food processing and storage. Both enzymatic and non-enzymatic Browning can affect the quality of food in either positive or negative ways, depending on the type of food. The major groups of reactions leading to Browning are enzymatic phenol oxidation and so-called non-enzymatic Browning. Enzymatic Browning. As the name says, enzymatic Browning is a Browning process which is caused by enzymes. Enzymes occur naturally in nature. There are a lot of different types of enzymes. Your body contains a whole variety, and fruits and vegetables contain a wide variety as well. Enzymes are a specific type of proteins. Enzymes function as a catalyst for a lot of chemical reactions. Enzymatic Browning is one of the most important color reactions that affect fruits, vegetables, and seafood. It is catalyzed by the enzyme polyphenol oxidase, often abbreviated with PPO, which is also referred to as phenol oxidase, phenolase, monophenol oxidase, diphenol oxidase, DPO, and tyrosinase. This enzyme catalyzes the reaction of phenols into polyphenols. These polyphenols are red, brown, or even black pigments that color the brown. A better understanding of the mechanism of enzymatic browning in fruits, vegetables, and seafood, the properties of the enzymes involved, and their substrates and inhibitors may be helpful for controlling browning development, avoiding economic losses, and providing high-quality foods. First, we will look at the properties of PPO. PPO is an oxidoreductase able to oxidize phenol compounds, employing oxygen as a hydrogen acceptor. PPO catalyzes two basic reactions: hydroxylation to the O position adjacent to an existing hydroxyl group of the phenolic substrate, monophenol oxidase activity, and oxidation of diphenol to O benzoquinones. PPO, active between pH 5 and 7, does not have a very sharp pH optimum. At lower pH values of approximately 3, the enzyme is irreversibly inactivated. Reagents that complex or remove copper from the prosthetic group of the enzyme inactivate the enzyme. Reaction mechanism of enzymatic browning. The formation of brown pigments consists of several steps. Step 1, hydroxylation of phenols. Enzymatic browning starts with monophenols. These are a group of molecules with a so-called phenol group. A phenol group is made up of a benzene ring attached to a hydroxyl group, O, see image below. The most important parts are the ring and O group. Other groups can be part of the molecule as well, for instance where the image now shows, and are for the reactions themselves. The phenol is more important. In the first step of enzymatic browning, an additional O group is added to the phenol group. As a result, it becomes a diphenol. This reaction is called a hydroxylation. In order for this reaction to occur, oxygen has to be present. Step 2, oxidation of diphenols. Again, oxygen is required to perform the next step. In this step, an oxidation reaction takes place in which the two O groups are transformed into a double bonded oxygen group. The resulting group of molecules are called quinones. Interestingly, different produce contains different PPO enzymes. Some are very good in catalyzing step 1, whereas others focus on step 2. As a result, the mechanism and especially rate of browning can be very different for different produce. Step 3, formation of colors. Quinones are very reactive molecules. They don't need any further help from enzymes to react further. The quinones will form polyphenols, large structures which will cause the actual discoloration. The pigments are called melanins. Substrates. Although tyrosine is the major substrate for certain phenolases, Other phenolic compounds such as caffeic acid and chlorogenic acid also serve as substrate. Here are some phenolic substrates of PPO in fruits, vegetables, and seafood. Phenolic compounds and PPO are, in general, directly responsible for enzymatic browning reactions in damaged fruits during post-harvest handling and processing. The relationship of the rate of browning to phenolic content and PPO activity has been reported for various fruits. In addition to serving as PPO substrates, phenolic compounds act as inhibitors of PPOs. Control of enzymatic browning. Processing such as cutting, peeling, and bruising is enough to cause enzymatic browning. The rate of enzymatic browning is governed by the active PPO content of the tissues, the phenolic content of the tissue, and the pH, temperature, and oxygen availability within the tissue. When controlling enzymatic browning, we can categorize the inhibition methods into three, with considering target compounds such as enzyme, substrate, and the products. Non-enzymatic browning. Non-enzymatic browning split into two categories as Maillard reaction and caramelization. Maillard browning. The Maillard reaction is an organic chemical reaction in which reducing sugars react with amino acids to form a complex mixture of compounds. The following must be there for Maillard browning to occur. 1. A compound with an amino group, typically an amino acid or protein, most commonly lysine. 2. A reducing sugar, most commonly glucose. 3. Water. Can follow the reaction by observing color formation, 420 or 490 nanometers in a spectrophotometer, or by following CO2 production. General effects. Flavor, color, odor. Decline in protein quality, usually a decline in digestibility as well as lysine availability. Temperature and or 0.6 to 0.7, favor the reaction. Desirable attributes. Color and flavor of baked, roasted and dried foods. Undesirable attributes. Off flavor. Texture, unintentional in products such as dried milk and mashed potatoes. Mechanism of the Maillard reaction. This reaction can be classified as a non-enzymatic browning reaction. The optimum temperature for this reaction ranges from 140 oC to 165 oC. It is important to note that caramelization is not a Maillard reaction. It proceeds at higher temperatures and involves the pyrolysis of sugars. The Maillard reaction mechanism begins with the formation of an N-substituted glycosamine, along with water, from the reaction between the amino group of the amino acid and the carbonyl group of the reducing sugar. Now, the glycosamine is transformed into ketosamines via a Madrid rearrangement. These ketosamines undergo further reaction via several pathways and can form reductones, butanediol, methylglyoxal, and several other products of short-chain hydrolytic fission. The ketosamines can also go on to form melanoidins and other brown nitrogenous polymers. This imparts the characteristic brown color to the food. It is important to note that the Maillard reaction between amino acids and reducing sugars can result in the formation of acrylamide, which is a possible carcinogen in humans. This compound is formed from the reaction between asparagine and dicarbonyl. Factors which affect browning. Water activity. Max at or 0.6, 0.7. pH. Neutral and alkaline pH is favored. Acid pH slows down or inhibits browning. Amino group on amino acid is protonated and glucosamine production prevented. Metals. Copper and iron catalyze browning. Catalyze oxidation, reduction type reactions. Temperature. Higher temperatures catalyzes linear up to 90 degrees Celsius, then more rapid increase. Carbohydrate structure. Pentoses, most reactive, hexoses, disaccharides, oligosaccharides, sucrose, least reactive. Fructose, ketose, is far less reactive than glucose, aldose. Concentration of open form. Pigment formation is directly proportional to the amount of open chain form. Inhibition, control of browning. Lower pH and T. Control or use non-reducing sugar. Remove substrate. For example, drying of egg whites. Add enzyme, D-glucose oxidase, prior to drying to oxidize glucose to glucano-delta-lactone. Use sulfating agents, most common chemicals used. React with carbonyls to prevent polymerization and thus pigment formation problems. Degrade thiamine, riboflavin and oxidize methionine. Can cause severe allergies. Undesirable consequences of browning. 1. Aesthetically and sensorially undesirable. Dark colors, strong odors and flavors. 2. Formation of mutagenic compounds. Data shows that some products from the reaction of D-glucose or fructose with L-lysine or L-glutamic acid may demonstrate mutagenicity. 3. Leads to anti-nutritional effects. Loss of essential amino acids. Primarily lysine, may be critical in lysine-limited foods, cereals, grain products. What is caramelization? Caramelization is a chemical reaction that takes place involving sugar in food. Therefore, we can define it as browning of sugar. This process gives the food its sweet, nutty flavor and brown color while cooking. There are three polymer groups which are responsible for the brown color of the food. They are 1. Caramelins, C24H36O18. 2. Caramelins, C36H50O25. 3. Caramelins, C125H188O80. During the progression of this process, some components of the food releases which are highly volatile. For example, it releases diacetyl components of food. This produces the characteristic caramel flavor of food. Moreover, this process is pyrolytic. This means the process involves the thermal decomposition of materials in food. The difference between Maillard reaction and caramelization is that the Maillard reaction is non-pyrolytic, whereas the caramelization is pyrolytic. This means, caramelization involves the thermal decomposition of materials in food, sugar, while Maillard reaction does not involve any thermal decomposition. It occurs via a chemical reaction between amino acids and reducing sugars in food. Okay, we believe that you obtain general knowledge on browning reactions. Thank you for stay with us till the last minute, so this is the bounce gift for you. If you need this video content, we will provide you this note to you. Keep a message in our Facebook page. We will put link below description section. Thanks for watching. Food Desk, it's all about food.